Hello friends, welcome to Awdhesh Academy. Friends, today we are going to discuss a case study which is asked in 2019 Civil Services Examination. And this case study relates to one of the disaster management issue. We know that in our country many times natural calamities like flood comes, and in that situation the entire administration seems to be totally helpless. People are very angry with the administration because they are unable to provide the relief material. And in that situation, it is also common that there is a conflict between the government and the public. So on this issue, a very interesting case study has been asked in 2019. So let's now read the case study. The case study is as following. You are heading the rescue operation in an area affected by severe natural calamity. Thousands of people are rendered homeless and deprived of food, drinking water, and other basic amenities. Rescue work has been disrupted by heavy rainfall and damage to supply routes. The local people are seething with anger against the delayed, limited rescue operation. When your team reaches the affected area, the people there heckle and even assault some of your team members. One of your team members is even severely injured. Faced with this crisis, some team members plead with you to call off the operations, fleeing threats to their life. Now the problem is that in such trying circumstances, what will be your response? Examine the qualities of the public servant which will be required to manage this type of situation. So friends, this is a very, very practical case study. We are seeing the floods in Patna, and we are seeing how angry the people are. And therefore, such types of case studies are very, very pertinent in the modern context. Let us now first analyze this particular case study. We know that in India, the disaster management system is quite poor. Whenever a flood occurs, whenever earthquake occurs, we find that government systems is found to be quite inadequate. The government departments are not adequately prepared to handle the natural calamities in our country. There is often a delay in providing relief material to the citizens because there is lack of resources and there is lack of manpower. So when the calamity is not there, then we don't feel the crunch. But when the calamity comes, then we suddenly realize how ill-prepared the government systems are. And when the relief material does not reach to the people, then people get angry with the government. Because India is a democracy and people expect the government to come to their rescue when they are in trouble. Now, when you are in such situation, when there is a huge flood or let us say earthquake, in that situation what happens that you are in a very emotional state of mind. And then sometime you lose your temper and you tend to misbehave with the government officer, whom you generally consider to be insensitive and indifferent to your problems. Therefore, even when the government officers are trying to help you, you sometimes don't find their attitude adequate and you tend to fight with them. And sometimes attacks also take place against the government officer. Some government officers are heckled also. Now, in that situation, what should we do? This is the pertinent question. Should we run away? Or should we continue with the relief work? So as a senior government officer, you have to understand the human psychology. You should understand that when we are in trouble, in distress, in very high emotional state of mind, in that situation, sometimes we act very irrationally. And therefore what happens that we tend to face the problems from the public who otherwise follow our orders. Now, government officers has to perform their duties under such adverse situation. This is a situation of natural calamities. Thousands and thousands of people are suffering. Government officer cannot run away from their duties and responsibilities, and therefore there is no question of withdrawing from it. We have to perform that duty. Now, we cannot punish the misbehavior of a few number of people to allow thousands and thousands of people to suffer because of the natural calamity. And hence, we have to move forward and help the people. However, we have to take adequate precautions while serving the people. and therefore we can seek the police protection, and under police protection we can continue to do the relief work. If there are some antisocial elements who try to disrupt our working, they can be rounded up, they can be arrested, and they can be punished according to the law. However, under no circumstances we should withdraw from the relief work, and we have to continue doing the relief work. Now the next part of the question is that what qualities of civil servants are required to manage such situation? There are many qualities which are required under such situation. I must say that almost all your qualities are under test to manage such type of situation. For example, integrity. In such situation, you have to ensure that all the relief material reaches to the people. If there is any act of corruption, that will spoil your reputation and that will create problem for you and your staff. Empathy. Empathy is very, very important, because the people are suffering, the people are frustrated, the people are angry. We have to put ourselves into their shoes, and then we can understand their feelings, and that is why empathy is also very important. Dedication to duty. This is a time not to think that you are doing any favor by helping the people, but it is your duty. And so dedication to duty is extremely important for all the government servants to perform their duty. Now, another very, very important quality which all civil servants must have under this situation is the quality of courage. Yes, there are threats. Yes, we are going to do something which actually is against the very antagonized people or angry people. But nevertheless, we have to show courage, and even if there is some threat, we must move ahead and do our duty. And for that, we require a spirit of service. So in this situation, your service attitude is of very importance, and it will be tested when you are going to serve the people. Patience is also very important. Even if suppose some people are shouting at you, some people are angry, we should have patience, and with patience we must perform our function. Another very important quality which comes to test here is the quality of impartiality. Because what happens that in such situation, when the resources are less, demands are more, there is a tendency to favor some people and not provide adequate support to other people. And this can infuriate the people, this can spoil the reputation of the government department. And therefore, we should be totally impartial, and we should see that all the people are given relief in a fair and just manner. And therefore, justice is another quality which is very, very important to be displayed in this particular type of situation. So friends, this way we can write an answer of this particular type of question, and we know very well that there is no option to go back from the relief operation. We have to carry out the relief operation, we have to take precautions, and we must develop these qualities as mentioned in this answer to perform our duties very well. Thank you very much for watching this lesson.